So, my friends, I don't know if you know, but the Publishers Weekly did a review of Quantum Body, the new science of living a longer, healthier, and more vital life. My book with quantum biologists and physicists Jack Tuzinski and Brian Fertig. It was the worst review I've ever received in my life. And I've received a lot of bad reviews, including for quantum healing. I've been vilified and criticized for being a pseudoscientist, been accused of by Richard Dawkins of willful obscurantism. He said it very much more elegantly. In his British accent or South African accent or Oxford accent. Deepak Chopra is guilty of willful obscurantism. And others have called my work pseudo profound bullshit. In fact, there's a random quote generator that people say can't differentiate between my quotes and the random quotes generated by this computer or whatever designed by somebody in Canada. So it pays actually to be in the conversation. My critics keep me in the conversation, and the publisher's weekly review was awful, awful, awful. And amongst other things, it criticized the book and me, particularly for talking about, what do vegetables and fruits or lentils have to do with quantum body? So, of course, as you know, I've been saying that plant-based foods are the closest we get to quantum, photons make them. But today I want to introduce you to another very important concept, and that is signal molecules and adaptogens. What are they, and why are they suggested for anti-aging purposes? Do they help promote a more youthful appearance and support overall health? So here are a few examples about the signal molecules and also their mechanisms of action. Let me go through them one by one. Number one, retinoids. Retinoids, such as retinol or retinoic acid, are derivatives of vitamin A. They work by stimulating collagen production, increasing cell turnover, and reducing the appearance of wrinkles and fine lines. Retinoids also help to even out skin tone and improve texture. Number two, peptides. Peptides are short chains of amino acids that play a crucial role in the overall health of the skin. Some peptides, like palmitil pentapeptide 4, work by promoting collagen production, which can lead to smoother, firmer skin and reduce signs of aging. Youthful aesthetics is part of the anti-aging program that is offered by the Chopra Foundation. Number three, antioxidants. Antioxidants such as vitamin C, vitamin E, and coenzyme Q10, CoQ10 as it's called, help to neutralize harmful free radicals that contribute to aging. They protect the skin from damage caused by environmental factors like pollution and UV radiation. Antioxidants also help to brighten the complexion and improve overall skin health. Number four, hyaluronic acid. Hyaluronic acid is a naturally occurring molecule found in the skin. It has the ability to attract and hold water, which helps to hydrate and plump the skin. Okay, that produces wrinkles. As we age, the production of hyaluronic acid decreases, leading to dryness and the appearance of wrinkles. Applying hyaluronic acid topically can help restore moisture and improve skin elasticity. Five, adaptogens are natural substances that help the body adapt to stress and promote resilience. While not specifically targeting anti-aging, they can indirectly support overall health and well-being, which may have a positive impact on aging. Examples of adaptogens include ashwagandha, used in Ayurveda, ginseng, used in Chinese medicine, and rhodiola. So this is some information on adaptogens, but right now there's a great interest in what are called signal molecules too. So let me go over them. The most important of these are quercetin, quercetin, Q-U-E-R-C-E-T-I-N, F-I-S-E-T-I-N, quercetin, and nicotinamide. These are three compounds that have been studied for their anti-aging effects. Here's how they may contribute to combating the aging process. Quercetin is a flavonoid. It's also found, by the way, in lots of fruits and vegetables. Quercetin, but you can get it as a supplement. So quercetin is a potent antioxidant. Its anti-aging effects are believed to stem from its abilities to scavenge free radicals and reduce oxidative stress. By neutralizing these harmful molecules, quercetin helps protect cells from damage, including DNA damage, which is associated with aging. Additionally, quercetin has been shown to have anti-inflammatory properties, which can help improve skin health and reduce signs of aging like wrinkles and fine lines. Quercetin, F-I-S-E-T-I-N, is another flavonoid that possesses antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties. Similar to quercetin, quercetin helps combat oxidative stress by neutralizing free radicals. It also activates certain pathways in the body, such as SIRT1. And this is a new area, sirtuins they're called. So the SIRT1 pathway, which is involved in regulating cell function and improving overall health. Research suggests that quercetin has the potential to extend lifespan and protect against age-related diseases by enhancing cellular health and reducing inflammation. Nicotinamide, NMN, as is frequently referred to, nicotinamide nucleotide, also known as niacinamide, is a form of vitamin B3 that is involved in various metabolic processes in the body. It is a precursor to the coenzyme called nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, NAD+, which plays a critical role in cellular energy production and DNA repair. As we age, NAD+ levels decline, which can negatively impact cell function. By supplementing with nicotinamide, it is theorized that NAD+ levels can be maintained, supporting cellular energy production and enhancing DNA repair mechanisms. This in turn may slow down the aging process and improve overall health. Recently, I've also come to know Augustinus Bader. He's a German scientist who has created a skin cream that I've been using a little bit. It's called Augustinus Bader, and Augustinus Bader is actually a very interesting scientist. The product that he has developed stimulates stem cell pathways in the skin. It may do other things. So I and Augustinus Bader are collaborating to possibly create a house of epigenetics very soon, where we'll be introducing not only, you know, these kinds of services and products, but going deeper into stem cell activation, vagal activation, metabolism of time, and everything that I've been speaking about in quantum body. And I'll keep you updated. Meanwhile, look up the literature on everything I've suggested as part of the quantum body anti-aging strategies. Okay, and that's it. If you want me to continue these conversations, let me know. Join the two courses, Peace is the Way and The Soul of Leadership. And help create a more peaceful, just, sustainable, healthier, and joyful world. Thank you.